Good morning, guys.
Good morning!
We have rain out there. It sounds pretty nice. It's not a hard rain. It's a good, gentle rain. And we're watering our garden. I think I watered it 3 times this year. Seems like it. Got quite a bit of tomatoes off of it. It's done pretty good. They kept the squirrels fed and the groundhog. It's fun. I'm getting wood in for the winter. We've got two. I got to get another cord of wood. That heat is so much better than the gas heat. It makes the room warm. The furniture can get warm. Or if you have electric heat or gas, the furniture is cold to the touch. Wood heat, it's warm. It's a whole different type of heat. This Saturday morning, September the 21st, looks like we got into chapter 4 of 2 Timothy. Man, this is going fast. How many chapters are in 2 Timothy? 4 or 5? Let me look here and see. Checking 73. There's 4. Yep, just 4. Wow, man, time's going by fast. Seems like it. There's a lot in these verses. When we dig into a verse or two, sometimes we get 2 verses. There's just so much that comes in it. And it's so neat just to be able to dig into them. Just amazing me. Let's see what we got here. This one is just verse 1. It says, I'm conjuring you in the sight of God and Christ Jesus, who is about to be judging the living and the dead in accord with his advent and his kingdom. All right, so that's verse 1. I appreciate Alicia and Judy pulling these. They go into the Unsearchable Riches or concordant.org somewhere, and they find pieces of articles that go with our verse. And for this one, Unsearchable Riches, James Corum brings out, I am conjuring you in the sight of God in Christ Jesus. Who is about to be judging the living and the dead, and according to his advent and kingdom, to herald the word, stand by it, opportunely, inopportunely, expose, rebuke, and treat with all patience and teaching. He brought in 2 Timothy 4, verses 1 and 2. This is a most solemn passage and full of gravity. Paul is conjuring or gravely charging Timothy, calling upon him to mark well these important instructions. He is doing so in the sight of God and Christ Jesus, who is about to be judging the living and the dead, in accord with his advent and his kingdom. Our requital at the dais of Christ will be in response to our practices, whether good or bad. 2 Corinthians 5:10. How's that? Is that? I didn't look, see what that, if there's anything else with that. 2 Corinthians 5:10. Let's see. For all of us must be manifested in front of the dais of Christ, that each should be requited for that which he puts into practice through the body, whether good or bad. Right? In order to reign or to have any allotment in the kingdom of Christ and of God, we must faithfully endure, 2 Timothy 2:12 and Ephesians 5:5. And all we do is done in the sight of God. He is aware. Having presented these facts for Timothy's awareness, Paul now gives his charge to herald the word. So, yeah, God knows. He's the one that gives us the belief. You know, one moment we know it and understand it, and the next moment it's or one moment we don't, rather. And then next, yeah, you want to say it?
One minute you don't know it, and then the next you do.
Right. It's just he just changes her mind. He opens her mind to things. You know, Scripture says that he might give us understanding. It's on the right-hand side. It's in Ephesians letters. Let me move this out of the way. I put that on my scriptures. Where's that at? It's right there on the right. Ephesians 3. On this behalf, I, Paul, the prisoner of Christ Jesus for you, the nations, since you surely hear of the administration of the grace of God that is given to me for you. That ain't the one I was thinking of. We've been given this, you know, this. Where's the talk about that? Given understanding. See, now I started something. I got to figure out where it's at. Oh, it's in verse chapter 2. It's on the right-hand side. I figured it was verse 17. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may be giving you a spirit of wisdom and revelation in the realization of Him. The eyes of your heart having been enlightened, and for you to perceive what is the expectation of His calling. So we've been given that. Those that are called have been given this. So that's just pretty awesome.
You know, it's either going to be on the right-hand side or the left-hand side.
Yeah, I wrote these out for several years. These studies. I didn't have a computer. I didn't have the ability to do this. So I hand wrote everything out. In my earlier videos, you know, I hand wrote everything. And Marcia knows I spent a lot of time at the kitchen table writing stuff.
Ignoring his wife.
I did. I was in the same room, but I was in Scripture. And just writing, man, I'd write and find these references and dig them through it.
I wouldn't have noticed it.
Try it now.
You still wouldn't notice. You go, oh, more
camera. would you iron them wrinkles out of that suit? That's one of them jokes I heard about the people that's walking. Anyway, you'll be sidetracked here in a minute. Be careful.
Right.
The DeBar translations for 2 Timothy 4:1 says, I thoroughly give testimony in the eye of God and of Christ Jesus, who is being about to judge the living and the dead ones, testifying both his appearing and his regency. We use a concordant literal for these studies and the references, and I'll leave it down below the video for you to see what we have in the order that I read them. So I'm conjuring you in the sight of God and Christ Jesus, who is about to be judging the living and the dead, in accord with his advent and his kingdom, to herald the word. Stand by it, opportunely, inopportunely. Expose, rebuke, entreat, with all patience and teaching. Contend the ideal contest of the faith. Get hold of Aeonian life for which you were called, and you avow the ideal avow in the sight of many witnesses. I'm charging you in the sight of God, who is vivifying all, and of Christ Jesus, who testifies in the ideal avow before Pontius Pilate, that you keep this precept unspotted, irrehensible, unto the advent of our Lord Christ Jesus. Those who are sinning, be exposing in the sight of all, that the rest also may have fear. I am conjuring you in the sight of God and Christ Jesus and the chosen messengers, that you guard these things apart from prejudice, doing nothing from bias. On no one place hands too quickly, nor yet be participating in the sins of others. Keep yourself pure. Of these things be reminding them, conjuring them in the Lord's sight not to engage in controversy for nothing useful, to the upsetting of those who are hearing. endeavor to present yourself to God qualified, an unashamed worker, correctly cutting the word of truth. From the profane prattlings, stand aloof, for they will be progressing to more irreverence. For not one of us is living to himself, and not one is dying to himself. For both, if we should be living, to the Lord are we living, and if we should be dying, to the Lord are we dying. Then both, if we should be living, and if we should be dying, we are the Lord's. For this Christ died and lives, that he should be Lord of the dead as well as the living. Now, why are you judging your brother? Or why are you also scorning your brother? For all of us should be presented at the dais of Christ. Yeah. For it is written, living am I, the Lord is saying, for to me shall bow every knee, and every tongue shall be acclaiming God. Consequently, then, each of us shall be giving account concerning himself to God. By no means, then, should we be judging one another, but rather decide this, not to place a stumbling block for a brother or a snare. Now, to me, it is the least trifle that I may be being examined by you or by man's day. But neither am I examining myself, for of nothing am I conscious as to myself, but not by this am I justified. Now he who is examining me is the Lord. So that be not judging anything before the season, till the Lord should be coming, who will be illuminating the hidden things of darkness and manifest the counsels of the heart. And then applause will be coming to each one from God. Can you imagine getting an applause from our Father? It's going to happen. Being this, courageous always, and aware that being at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For by faith are we walking, not by perception. Yet we are encouraged and are delighting rather to be away from home out of the body and to be at home with the Lord. Wherefore we are ambitious also, whether at home or away from home, to be well pleasing to him. For all of us must be manifested in front of the dais of Christ, that each should be requited for that which he puts into practice through the body, whether good or bad. For the saving grace of God made its advent to all humanity, training us that, disowning irreverence and worldly desires, we should be living sanely and justly and devoutly in the current eon, anticipating that happy expectation, even the advent of the glory of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gives himself for us that he should be redeeming us from all lawlessness and be cleansing for himself a people to be about him, zealous for ideal acts. Speak of these things and entreat and expose with every injunction. Let no one slight you. We ought to be thanking God always concerning you, brethren, according as it is meet, as it is worthy, seeing that your faith is flourishing and the love of each one of you all for one another is increasing, so that we ourselves glory in you in the ecclesia of God for your endurance and faith in all your persecutions and the afflictions which you are bearing, a display of the just judging of God to deem you worthy of the kingdom of God for which you are suffering also. If so be that it is just of God to repay affliction to those afflicting you, and to you who are being afflicted, ease with us at the unveiling of the Lord Jesus from heaven with his powerful messengers, in flaming fire, dealing out vengeance to those who are not acquainted with God and those who are not obeying the evangel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall incur the justice of Aeonian extermination from the face of the Lord and from the glory of his strength, whenever he may be coming to be glorified in his saints and to be marveled at in all who believe, seeing that our testimony to you was believed in that day. You know, that eonian extermination is a temporary thing. All will be made alive, the scripture says. For this we are saying to you by the word of the Lord, that we, the living, who are surviving to the presence of the Lord, should by no means outstrip those who are put to repose. For the Lord himself will be descending from heaven with a shout of command, with the voice of the chief messenger, and with a trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall be rising first. Thereupon we, the living, who are surviving, shall at the same time be snatched away together with them in clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Man, what a day that's going to be. And thus, and thus we shall be with always, we shall always be together with the Lord, so that console one another with these words. Can you imagine what day that's going to be like? Woo! Furthermore, there is reserved for me the wreath of righteousness, which the Lord, the just judge, will be paying to me in that day, yet not only to me, but also to all who love his advent. If then you arouse together with Christ, be seeking that which is above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. Be disposed to that which is above, not to that on the earth, where you died, and your life is hid together with Christ and God. See, we died with Christ on the cross. We were entombed with him, and we have been roused with him. Speaking of a future event, so it's going to happen. We will be roused with him, be made vivified. Whenever Christ, our life, should be manifested, then you also should be manifested together with him in glory. I like that scripture over in Romans, chapter 8. Let me get over to it. I'll put y'all in the wrong spot when I set it up here. I hadn't planned on doing this. But this one on the left side.
You sure?
Yeah, it's on the left. Yet you are not in flesh, but in spirit. Right? If so be that God's spirit is making its home in you. Now, if anyone has not Christ's spirit, this one is not his. Now, if Christ is in you, the body indeed is dead because of sin. Yet the Spirit is life because of righteousness. Now, if the Spirit of him who rouses Jesus from among the dead is making its home in you, he who rouses Jesus Christ, or Christ Jesus from among the dead, will also be vivifying your mortal bodies because of his spirit making its home in you. That's just pretty neat stuff. That's neat. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, pitiful compassions, kindness, humility, meekness, patience. And patience. Bearing with one another and dealing graciously among yourselves. If anyone should be having a complaint against any, according as the Lord also deals graciously with you, thus also you. Now, over all these, put on love, which is the tie of maturity. And let the peace of Christ be arbitrating in your hearts, for which you were called also in one body, and become thankful. That's our references for 2 Timothy 4:1, besides one that I put in there just to see. But we've got such a blessing being given the understanding of the scripture that we've been given. You know, Mom and Dad, I've told you all, Mom and Dad come into this back in the 70s. And Dad tried to show it to me off and on through the years, and I didn't want to have anything to do with it. My first video was in July of 2016. And at that time, I didn't understand really what was going on. I was unsure. I was still going to church. And, so, you know, one moment we see it, and before that, we had no idea. We didn't make any sense to us. But when I understood, and I remember the day I was walking, I was doing a video walking up the hill, up our driveway, back when we lived in the timber, and understanding that we have been saved from death. That's where we've been saved from, is from death. We have been saved, we're being saved from death, that we will no longer be in that state. Our bodies are dying, or we're dying constantly. And to be vivified, to be brought out among that, from among the dead, to be made alive, that you can never die again, and be vivified, be glorified as Christ is. We are his body. Wow. Man, there's so much to be thankful for through Paul's letters when we see them. The risen Christ gave this message to Paul, or to Saul. And he wrote it out. The Spirit let him write it out or inscribe, and it's for us today. Two evangels, one for the earthly realm, and Paul's letters are for those that's for the celestial realm. Yeah, our realm is inherent in the heavens, out of which we are awaiting a Savior also, Lord Jesus Christ, who will transfigure the body of our humiliation to conform it to the body of his glory. Something like that. Anyway, I love you guys. I'm getting long. Appreciate you being with us. Marcia, you anything you want to say?
I love you guys. Every one of you. Yeah.
Thanks for the phone calls and the emails and the texts. We appreciate it very much. And we'll talk to y'all tomorrow. See you then.